deserve to hear this far. We've gone through the fire and here we are. There ain't nothing we can't do, 'cause you've got me and I've got you.
Welcome back to Code S. We have our final match. It is the winner of the loser's match, the loser of the winner's match, and Steve vs. Genius. This is a PvP, and in Korean and chat, Genius has just told us all that he hates Protoss vs. Protoss. He hates to do Protoss vs. Protoss. Unfortunately, he has to do Protoss vs. Protoss. And as I was saying earlier, you know, that last match was so important for him because PvZ, Genius is almost unstoppable, but now he has to play a PvP, and he was so close to winning. In that one game where he had an advantage, where he was up a game on Supernova, if he had just been patient, he would be in Kodos right now. But now he's going to be stressed out because he lost the final game, and now he's playing a PvP against someone who's great at PvP.
I'm actually looking really forward to this PvP match because we've seen in the last few days, especially at MLG, a lot of great Kodos versus Kodos matches. We've just talked a little bit earlier with Mr. Che about Naniwa's second game against Huck. All of you who watched the series will definitely remember it. It was just insane. One of those games that just completely blow your mind because you have no idea what's happening. It would be great to see something as exciting as we've seen at MLG today here in our GSL Code S match between Seed and Genius. Right into the match. This is GSL Code S. Aldo and Wolf. We are on Ohana, one of the new maps in the GSL map pool. To the bottom right, we have the incredible Miracle player. He was just able to defeat Boom Boom Prime. He used the Foregate on the second map, surprised his opponent, took advantage of the situation.
IMC
was definitely unpredictable in this game, and now he is up against a fellow Protoss player. He's up against the player for Team MVP. Starting to the top left of the map, we have the Genius in the blue color, starting Chrono Boosted Economy.
MVP Genius!
Just stated a few seconds ago that Protoss versus Protoss is not really his favorite matchup.
No, not. You know, I think Boom Boom's probably going to be feeling okay about his loss because, as we saw, he feels he's not ready yet for Code S. And, you know, I think he definitely has a lot of refinement left in his play. Genius's PvP is not PvP, it's PK.
Genius going second pylon before gas. That is actually unheard of. That's just really weird.
What does the master of Foregate have to say about this matchup?
Well, I think on this particular map,
guys. Just a quick note, when Wolf was starting with coming from the Master of Foregate, I really thought, I looked at him and was like, what? Seed, the Master of Foregates against Zerg? What is happening? And then he was like, me!
I was so ready to Foregate an ST and FXO versus IM, but the thing is, QXC is an all-kill man, so I didn't get to show my stuff, but the world, I know the world was looking forward to it. I told everyone I was going to do it too. Nesty probably even heard he was scared he was going to make three spine crawlers blindly against me and still lose to my Foregate, but Anyway, enough of that. We have a second gas taken very early for Genius here. And, you know, I think the King of Fourgate here says that if you take a second gas that early, it can be kind of risky if your opponent has saved as much chrono as Seed has. And Seed will see the Zealot has been made here and will also see the second gas.
One thing to note is that this is a very new map. As you could just see, we have a single file ramp into the main base. So there's definitely the potential to defeat Fourgate play. Fourgate can be quite risky here. So something that we have to take into consideration. There are a lot of strategies that you can use. We have at the bottom of the natural expansion a little bit of a broader ramp. Kind of the style that we see, for example, on Antigua. The ramp is not as wide, though.
Right. You know, it's very similar to Antigua Shakura's Plateau, if you guys remember that map. Even in Tomb Valley.
Now, the rush distances between the two positions are not that big, and we have those Tuxilnaga watchtowers in the middle of the map that obviously just spot a huge area.
Whoa, someone's going to go Phoenixes in the GSL. This happens a lot on the ladder, but not as often in actual Korean tournament play. Seed getting the better hit here initially, but now Genius has the Stalkers to push him back. This is actually really interesting. I can't wait to see this Phoenix play come in here. He takes out the probes, so now he can actually be very safe. He's not going to be that concerned about his opponent.
I actually expected this on a map like Ohana. We saw it in the GSTL. Choi was using it in the PvP with double Stargate on Calm Before the Storm, which was very, very effective, especially when unscouted. And you get a huge amount of Phoenixes and suddenly attack, your opponent might just lose the game. In this particular match, Joya's opponent was going for Robotics tech and already had a Robotic Space, so the Colossi were kind of defenseless against the Phoenixes, but this time it's a little bit of a different story.
This type of build has so many different branches. You can do the Phoenix Probe Harass build. You can do the Phoenix Fourgate all-in. You can try to pick up sentries. You can make that your priority. You can try to harass and expand and then try to go back and use your Phoenix energy to defend against your opponent's counterattack. Oh, this is the best case scenario for Genius. If
yes.
Your opponent goes blindly Robotic Support Bay, this is the type of play that's actually the safest in most cases in the exact same way that I play on the ladder. So whenever someone like Genius comes and just goes Phoenixes, I lose. I get really frustrated, but Seed may lose in a similar fashion if he just blindly goes, well, I didn't take a lot of risks. I took a lot of risks. I didn't make any sentries, really. I'm just going to go super fast Colossi. I'm going to have faster Colossi than him, and I'm going to be ready for his blink play if he goes for that. But Phoenix play can really, really put a damper on this type of tech choice.
And now just moving out, trying to get a little bit aggressive. Obviously, just dodging the Xilanga Watchtower, which is so important, trying to sneak in into the economy so that he can start lifting off a few of the probes and take them down.
Ooh, he's probably going to get this sentry right now.
Yes, he is. Takes down the sentry right away and heads into the main base. There is no anti-air whatsoever at this point.
The fastest Colossus cancel I've ever seen, man. He even wasted a chrono on it. Gets out of there, and Genius now throws on expansion. Notice Genius didn't pick up probes, not because of those Stalkers. He could have easily escaped, but because he knows he's going to need lifts to defend his Nexus. He absolutely cannot use lifts to pick up probes right now, because he's going to need those defensively whenever Seed moves out, which it might be soon. Now, Seed has to make a choice here. He's making his own Nexus, which is smart, but does he try to pressure his opponent's Nexus? Because if he does, and Genius comes home, then he loses probes, but if he doesn't move out, then Genius just gets his Nexus up faster for free with less units. So it's a tough position to be in against Phoenixes.
It definitely is. They are just so fast. It's a little bit... a bit compared to Mudalus Keras, you might just lose your entire economy, so just having those Phoenixes on the map brings suddenly Genius in a position where he just can force his opponent to be defensive, which is exactly what he does here, just trying to get some scouting information, getting in there and showing the Phoenixes, making sure that his opponent just stays put for now.
A wise man, Artosis, once told me that if you go Phoenixes in PvP, your opponent does not have Phoenixes, and even if he does, you should never lose a Phoenix. It's actually true. Without Blink, you will never, ever, ever kill a Phoenix if your opponent is on top of his controller. That will never happen. You probably will never even lose real hit point damage. You'll only lose shields, but with the good control of Genius, he's obviously showing his opponent that he's saving his lifts and that he is going to be ready to defend. Now, back at home, he has Colossi on the way, and things are just looking really good for Genius right now. Seed doesn't know if there are more Phoenixes than this or not.
He has very limited scouting information. He's actually checking now with his observer, though, so he is going to see. Okay, it looks like he stopped Phoenix production. I wonder, though, did he see the robotic support bay? That is the question, because without that, it could be anything as a follow-up here, and I'm sure he's likely seen this. I just can't check right now, unfortunately.
With the setup that we are currently using, we can't really, we don't have any control of the game, so that we can't really check if there's a robotics, if he spotted it or not. So we have to rely on Legend here. And at this point, we have both of them now with the first Immortals. As you can see, it's just in regards to the supply and everything, they are about even, but the Colossus tech is now coming up for Genius, who at this point starts extended thermal land, so he will have the first Colossus in the game. Actually, he won't, because right now we also have foreseen the first Colossus.
Yeah, the range is going to be important, especially with Phoenixes on the map, because if Seeds, Colossi have to close further distance, then of course the Phoenixes will... If the Colossi have to get closer to the Phoenixes can do more damage. Forge going down now for Seed, that's really smart. This is something we've seen him do in his PvPs that go to late game. We saw him at the Fnatic tournament do this quite often, getting a Forge faster than his opponent oftentimes to get those upgrades out, because as the game goes longer, those attack upgrades do become important because the scaling of damage for Colossi is actually out of control. Second Robo going down for Genius now. The only vulnerability this has is some sort of Void Ray transition, but since he has Phoenixes to scout, he'll know inevitably that no matter what his opponent does, if he tries to make a different choice, he'll know about it with his Phoenixes. And without Blink, he won't be able to stop the Phoenixes, and he won't be able to get Blink without Genius knowing about it. It's actually just such a good build. Phoenixes are so strong, it's very difficult to deal with them, especially if you don't have a lot of experience with it, which Seed has been dealing with this very calmly so far, but even so, he's just behind in so many ways right now.
He also has only a few Immortals. We have a higher Immortal count at this point for Genius, and it's going really well for him because he is just picking off a few sentries, putting on pressure onto his opponent, making sure that he has the double Colossal production, so he will have the higher count. And if he heads with a decent timing here, he will be able to do so much damage.
Notice that because he knows that Phoenixes are not really going to be useful in a fight anymore with the army large enough, now he's starting to use his energy to pick up probes and not before. And because he's using that energy now, he also was able to get close enough to the Forge to scout it, so he's going to be getting his own Forge. He's not going to get himself behind in upgrades too badly. He's actually deciding to move out and be aggressive here.
Moving out with just a few Stalkers is definitely risky, because when the Phoenixes just suddenly hit, they can't pick them off, and if you run into the army, you might just lose them, which we just did not see happening because the Phoenixes were a bit out of position, but it was definitely a problem that he would have had to face.
There's a really, really good timing here for Genius to move out, because he knows his opponent just added his second Robotics Bay, so he's actually going to move out. He's hoping he can hit before his opponent's plus one finishes, but that may not be the case here. But he knows he's going to have a Colossus lead. If he waits for that next one that's about to pop out, he'll go with a pretty big lead. He's going to try to draw the forces into the main before he goes.
He should definitely try to exploit this advantage. We have cannons now in the mineral line, so this will obviously allow Seed at some point to already move out and not have to fear those Phoenixes just going rampage and going wild in the main base.
Now, if he uses his Immortals correctly, the Colossi should be able to wipe out the Zealots before they become an issue, and then the Immortals can actually just do so much damage to the army, the Stalker-heavy army of Seed. Seed has much more Stalkers, but with those extra Immortals in there, it's going to be tough. Cannons being added now for Genius for possible DT play. He wants to be careful of that. You know, it's possible his opponent is hidden a shrine somewhere. He just wants to be completely sure also of Warp Prism play and things like that.
Both of them really reluctant to attack here. It is the last best of three of the day, ladies and gentlemen, and this is so important. They have a lot of respect for each other. Not pushing out just yet. Both of them just preparing for this big attack, and still the Phoenixes in play, able to scout, able to pick off the additional probe, but obviously also just getting a huge amount of scouting information, and whoa, taking on the shields of all of these Colossi.
Yep, and still not losing any Phoenixes. Now, I'd really love to see the worker count right now, because that is something that would be a pretty big tell, because he's had to kill, I mean, even though they're both probably on optimal saturation, he's had to make a lot more probes, a lot more resources pumping into that. Templar Archives is on the way now for Seed, knowing I think that his worker, I mean, look at that, 53 to 51, so very similar probe counts, but Seed has had to make additional probes to keep up with Genius. Now, because their Colossal count is so similar, it's hard to say who will really win this fight. The advantages in units are going to be pretty negligible. What's going to be most important is positioning. Who will have the better concave? Whose zealots will connect better? And where will the immortals hit targets that they're supposed to hit? All of these questions will be answered when the battle commences, but until that moment, we will not know.
We have a sick Colossi count here. He also already has 8 Colossi. He's getting additional 2, and there we go. 9 Colossi, 53 to 50 drones, and additional Zealot
count is similar. The only difference is in Stalkers, but with the extra mortals there, the Colossi count is important. Genius may decide to commit now. I think it would be a great idea for him to commit now. His opponent is so clumped up. He's going for it. The Zealot's tanking some hits here, but Genius is actually doing damage with his Phoenixes as well. The Immortal's getting all their hits in, and I think Genius is going to crush this army.
Yes,
no doubt in my mind. The Phoenixes taking out the Colossi as they retreat. This Nexus will go down a terrible choice, I think, to make a Nexus in this case.
9-5 Colossi at this point. We still have the Phoenixes going strong. Yes, just such an amazing army. The War of the Worlds, it's once again commencing. We have now a few Arcans getting into the picture, but at this point, is there anything that he can do? He's already 35 supply behind his opponent, and now we have Genius with the third base. He's taking his third, he's still building additional Colossi. This is not going well for Seed.
No, it is not, man. And look at this, Genius is actually going to get a great position where to defend, he has to clump up his Colossi, and that's exactly what he's going to do. Genius having a very good concave, and there's nothing he can do. Not all of Genius's Colossi are firing, though, and the engagement going better for Seed than it should have, but the Immortals now closing the distance, and look at that. The Phoenix even adding in some extra hits. It's just too much.
He's spreading out his army. He's taking on Seed's units, and this is beautiful unit control here by Genius as well. And at this point, the game is over with only 50 supply left. He has to GG out of the game. Seed loses the first map. Genius taking game number one.
Genius with a great build order, beautiful execution. His macro is better than his opponent's because of the early lead he got, and therefore his composition became better, but also his choice to engage there at the last moment where his opponent's units were clumped up was genius, to say the least. I was very impressed. Now, when Keldor said earlier that we're having a War of the Worlds now, if anyone is listening by radio broadcast right now and don't have any actual stream, he's talking about Colossi versus Colossi. Don't have a mix-up like the George Orwell War of the Worlds mix-up where people start panicking. Don't panic, okay? We may have another War of the Worlds type situation next game in a PvP, but don't look outside afraid for your lives or anything like that. There are no real Colossi here.
We have a picture. We have just had a shot of the IM coach, and it's actually his birthday today.
Oh, I didn't know that.
What? You didn't say, you didn't congratulate him?
I didn't even see him in the studio yet, but I will make sure to do that before I leave. I'm like, thanks, Mom, I'll tell him.
Careful, Sunshine.
No, I will tell him. I had no idea, actually. I hadn't run into him until now, so that's my first time seeing him since he's been here.
Yeah. Well, maybe Seed will be able to give him a small birthday present here, but so far Genius looked pretty dominant. And next map is going to be Daybreak.
Yep. It's going to be it's the map choice, of course, of Seed. Now this map is a lot different than the last map. There's a lot more attack avenues. Charge Zealots are the only real unit composition that is favored on this map, I guess you could say, because of the wide entrance of the natural and because there's so many different attack pathways you can try to flank. But otherwise, this map is very standard. Blink Stalker play is not very good on this map because it's very difficult to blink into the main. There's not a lot of entrances to blink into. You have to basically fight at the natural to even blink up there. So Blink Stalker expand builds are not good. Blink Stalker all-ins are fairly normal, and Charge Zealots, of course, Charge Zealot a little bit stronger. Blink Stalker throughout the entire mid-game is weaker. Those are the only things to really take into account. We'll see what build Seed does on this map, see if he can try to bring this back to a 1-1 series, or will Genius go on to Codess like everyone expects? This is the GSL Codess with Kaldor and Wolf. Don't go anywhere, we're getting into the game right now.